Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, Life of a Network Engineer. This channel will be more into networking and also other learnings what I learned throughout my life. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. Let's skip to the video. So we have been running a series of configurations like BGP, OSPF. So in this video, we'll be looking into how to configure basic EIGRP between two routers. So for this, I have already set up a EVNG lab. And in here, I have put two routers, C1 and CE2 and VPC1 and VPC2 are the PCs. Well, let's start configuring them one by one. So in VPC1, I'm just going to go give the IP 10.1.1.5/24 and the gateway will be 10.1.1.1. Okay. Similarly, for VPC2, we'll set something as IP 10.1.2.5/24 and the gateway will be 10.1.2.1. Okay. Now we'll set the CE1 and CE2. So basically CE1 and CE2 don't have anything. I'm going to configure the interfaces 0/0, which is connecting to VPC1, and 3/0, which is connected to the next router. So 0/0 is interface, and I'm going to give the IP address the gateway, which is 10.1.1.1.255.255.255.0. For interface 3/0, I'm going to give the IP address 192.168.1.1.255.255.255.252. Okay, as these are all unshared, we'll leave it to this and we'll start configuring the CE2 router. So here also again we'll have to configure the same IP interfaces 0/0 and 3/0. We'll just cross verify that 0/0 is connected to VPC2, 3/0 will be connected to next router. So we'll start configuring that interface 0/0. Here the gateway IP address will be 10.1.2.1.255.255.255.0 and the next interface will be 3/0, for which the IP address will be 192.168.1.2.255.255.255.255. Now let's verify that if the gateway is pinging. The PC is pinging. Now we'll cross verify if the /30 IP is pinging. It's pinging. The IP address is reachable. Now we'll start configuring the EIGRP. So first we'll configure that in CE1. Conf router EIGRP 100, and we'll have to just put one command, which is network 192.168.1.0 and the wildcard mask. Now the reason why we are putting wildcard mask is, if suppose we don't put a wildcard mask, it will take us classful subnet. Okay, so to make that as a classless, we'll have to put the wildcard mask here. So it will be 0.0.0.3. We'll also put no auto summary, and the main command is redistribute connected. So as to redistribute the connected routes, which are 10 segments. We'll go into CE router 2, CONFT, similarly router EIGRP 100, network 192.168.1.0.0.0.0.3, and then can see that already the neighbor is up. We'll configure the no auto summary as well and the redistribute connected. For redistribute connected, we can either give redistribute connected so that this 10 segment will be redistributed, or you can give the network IP here so that network 10.1.2.0 and the wildcard mask, so that that will also advertise the connected subnets. Now we'll see if the EIGRP is up. And see the EIGRP is up for 29 seconds, and we'll see in the show IP route. So here you can see that it is D external. Okay, D is EIGRP, so it's an external EIGRP here. You can see that 10.1 is reachable from here. Cross testing, what we'll have to do is ping from this VPC to that VPC, and finally I'll give you a small clue on why it is EX, so we can manipulate that to a normal EIGRP route instead of external. Now it's ping 1.1.1. We'll try that first. It's reachable. Now we'll ping 1.5. As you see, it is VPC2. We are trying to ping to 1.5. It's reachable. Okay, perfect. Now we'll see how to change this external route to normal EIGRP. It's very simple. We'll have to just go to router EIGRP 100 and no redistribute connected. We'll remove it and then give the network command 10.1.2.0. I think it might take as a classful. We'll check that out. We'll have to see that in the C1. Yeah, so you can see here D is now D, it's not external, it's just EIGRP. So you might have a confusion that we saw that EX in the next router. So what I'll do is I'll just configure here as well. Router EIGRP 100, no redistribute connected, and then network 10.1.1.0 set. Now we'll see what has happened in the C router. So you can see here it was EX before, which is an external route, and now it is just D. Thanks for watching, guys. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. In our next video, we'll be looking into how to configure EIGRP in advanced mode. Happy learning.